If confirmed, how can we be sure that you just won't look the other way in dealing with this issue of sexual assault at the National Park Service like you did with your own potential boss to president-elect?
Well, thank you for the question. And I take issues of sexual assault, harassment, absolutely seriously. As you know, as a military commander, the tolerance is zero.
Have you had a conversation with the president-elect about his statements?
No, Senator, I have not. But I have had conversation about the Park Service. And there are problems in the Park Service. There are problems in sexual harassment. There's problems in morale. If you look at the Park Service, I mean, who would not want to be a ranger? Mm-hmm. Historically, the job of a ranger in the Park Service has been one of the top positions as far as employee satisfaction. Today, they're ranked at the bottom. Now, something's going on, whether it's sexual harassment has an influence on it, whether they feel like they don't have the flexibility to make decisions, whether they feel there's a lot of reasons, but I got to get to the bottom of it because it's the front line, and you've served, and thank you for your service. You've served, and you understand if the morale is bad at the front line, it makes sure that mission success isn't going to happen. And sexual harassment is part of what's killing morale, I believe. But I'm going to go out in the front line and talk and listen to what's happening because one is on the sexual harassment issue. They have to know from leadership, from the top and the bottom, that we have zero tolerance.
I hope in addition to listening, you'll create a work environment so that victims will be willing to come forward without fear of retaliation. Because we're hearing, you know, very, very serious things related to this.
Yes, ma'am, and you have my absolute commitment. I do take it seriously. The work environment is incredible. And we have, you know, there's 70,000 professional men and women within the Department of Interior. And when you walk in the door in the morning, you should absolutely have the right expectation of a work environment that is conducive to success. And if there is a culture of sexual harassment, that's just flat wrong. And I'm gonna stamp it out, if confirmed.